that feels good, anything that you are comfortable, like just noticing that there's a connection that you have to the earth. If sitting cross-legged doesn't work, you know that you could always extend your legs. You could sit kneeling, but just find that place and then rest your hands. Actually, go ahead and bring your hands together into a Namaste Mudra, and then bring the hands down and release the palms so the palms come apart so the fingertips are still touching. Yeah, and if that feels a little awkward, then you can relax a little bit more. Don't worry about it too much, but have the sensation of fingertips touching. Take a full breath in through your nose, and a big exhale out your mouth and let it go. And soften your jaw and your tongue. And soften the inside of your mouth. Relax your neck. Relax your shoulders. And just bring awareness to where you are. Just notice where you are today and what you're coming with, right? A lot of changes are happening again. And some of us are okay with change and some of us are not. You know, it's harder. Even if it's positive, sometimes just a disruption to our routine is something to fear, which I totally understand now. Maybe you're not feeling any of that. Maybe you're just very happy to be here, very content with your body, with the present situation, with your life, with everything, and that's good too. That's that as well. But for the next maybe 2 minutes or so, let's just practice just coming back to our breath and coming back into this moment. And in this moment, what is real is your breath, what is real is your body, what is real is that all is well. And that is all. Notice your feet and the muscles around your ankles and the arches of your feet. Notice the shin bones and the knees and the heaviness in the thighs. Let your hips be content and connected. Allow your pelvis to be still and connected. Relax your belly. Allow your shoulders to be relaxed. Neck and your jaw and your tongue. Again, relax all of that. Bring your awareness to your fingertips touching. And maybe like notice the energy between your hands a little bit. Kind of bring your awareness there. Like feel how the fingertips are touching and the space between your palms and how that feels. And relax again your head. In your forehead and maybe any tension in your neck, like let that go as well. And just be present. That's it. Just be in the moment where you're at and be present where you're at. And as you notice your thoughts, right, come in and out, come back to this moment. Come back to your body. Come back to your breath. And you always have a choice. You have a choice to either follow sort of the thoughts in your brain that are over and over again, whatever's going on, anything that you're creating, or you have a choice to follow the present moment, which is just that you're sitting on a space, on your mat, listening to my voice, allowing yourself to relax a little bit, practicing your breath. Breath is always going to bring you back. Always going to bring you back. And just take another moment here. And then slowly just bring your hands back to each other. So you press from the fingertips and the palms and you reunite sort of in this Anjali Mudra at your heart center, and you notice the sensation now as you re-glue your hands and how it feels sealed and complete. And you take a moment and set an intention for your practice. And I'll just ask you to personally take a deep breath in. Exhale out your mouth and let it go. Bow your chin into your chest and open up your eyes. All right, awesome. So we're just gonna come onto our hands and knees. So from here, just spread out your fingers nice and wide. You're gonna root into all of your knuckles, get every single knuckle to press down, and curl your toes under. And we're gonna move with the breath. Toes curled under as you inhale with your chest and look up. And then as you exhale, untuck the toes and press the floor away and round. And then do it again. Inhale, curl the toes under the chest and look up. And exhale, press the tops of the feet into the floor, round the spine. And then go one more time. Inhale, curl the toes under, gaze up towards the sky. And then exhale, tops of the feet press down as you round through your spine. Inhale, just find a neutral pelvis, curl your toes under. Exhale, extend your left leg straight out beside you. Okay, so outer edge of your left foot is sealed, tailbone in. And then from here, take another breath in. Lift your left arm up to the sky. So you're going to twist open to the left. Yeah. And then exhale, your left hand down. And then inhale, lift your right arm. So move away from the extended left leg. And you're going to feel a little more, oh yeah, a little more stretchy there. And then exhale, your right arm under, think thread the needle. Okay, so right arm under, thread the needle. Yeah, good. And you can press with your left hand to give yourself a little more leverage. And you'll feel yourself creating some space in between the shoulder blades. That should feel really good, actually. Good, one more breath there. Exhale it out. And then come back to center as you inhale. Press your hands into the floor and come all the way up. Good job. And then left arm comes down. Inhale, stretch the right side of the body. Exhale, side bend over to your left side. Yeah, so we're going to be doing a lot of side bending, a lot of oblique work today, opening up the channels on either side of the spine. One more full breath in. Exhale, release. Inhale, bring both arms up. Exhale, reach over to your right side, and your right hand comes down, and your left leg comes up. So this is a modified side plank, and it's not too easy, right? Sometimes it's tricky to balance here. Okay, I'm going to take another breath in, and then maybe you bend your left knee and catch your left foot. That's another little Shavasana fun, right? This is called sugar cane. So you press into your hand and squeeze your shoulder blades together and bow the body sideways. And go one more breath there. And then release your foot and release your arm. Use your core to come all the way up. And then bring your hands down. Slide your left knee in. Extend your right leg out. Okay. So we know where we're going, so we're gonna go a little more flow this time. Inhale, twist to your right, right arm up. And exhale, right hand down. Inhale, left arm up. And then exhale, twist, left arm under. Okay, so you're pausing here just for a breath or two, because it feels really good just to give yourself a little leverage. So push your right hand into the floor. And give yourself a little more space, almost like you're pulling your shoulder blade out. And breathe into that space right there in your back. One more breath in. Exhale it out. On your inhale breath, come up, and then use your core and you push the floor away to come up. Yeah. And then inhale here and exhale, side bend over to your right. Right over that extended right leg to the right. Yeah, there it is. And you can let your right arm come down if you want. Yeah, Michelle. Mm-hmm. And one more breath there. Stay there. Exhale. And then you're going to come all the way up. Here's where you want to turn on your core. And you take your left arm down and you just whoo. There it is. And the right leg lifts. Good. And you can stay right there, or you can bend your right knee and catch your right foot. And you're. Sides of the body are different, right? So just know that maybe the other side felt different or easier or harder. See if you can still roll the shoulder blades in towards each other to open up the heart. Like push the back of the heart to the front. One more breath there. You're gonna release that on your exhale and just reach up. And then inhale to come all the way up. Yes. And then exhale, hands to the floor. Slide your right we'll feel out that downward facing dog. Spread your fingers, anchoring every knuckle. Maybe moving the hips from side to side, kind of just depending on how you feel.
Inhale here.
Stay for your exhale. Look ahead, look forward actually, and bend your knees, either step or float to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, maybe hands to shins. And then exhale, fold forward. And bend your knees now and find ragdoll pose. So a lot of deep bending here. Maybe grab your elbows. You can do a little sway here from side to side. And just let the side of the body stretch. Just easy does it. We're just starting, right? We're just starting. Take another breath there. Stay for your exhale. Release your hands from your elbows and catch your hips. And as you inhale, come all the way up with a flat. And then hands to your heart center. So not CTP, bring the big toes together. Okay, so just take a second. Come back to that intention again. And we know the intention for our practice can be an intention that you set for the rest of your day. That's how powerful it can be. So just remind yourself that's what we're here for. Take a full breath in. Exhale out your mouth and let it go. Good. Inhale, sweep your arms up to the sky. And as you do that, you're going to catch your hands, interlace your fingers, and release your index fingers. And then wiggle your hips a little bit to get your spine a little longer. Take a breath there. Exhale, side bend over to your right side. Okay. So pull a little bit on your left hand to increase the sensation across the left side of the body, right? And then anchor down through your left heel. Okay? So keep your left heel pushing down. Now take your tailbone into the body and the ribs back of the belly in. Take another breath and really stretch kind of up a little bit. And then exhale, go the furthest that you can go. Like really go for it. And then inhale, come back to center. Open up your hands and relace your fingers, cross the thumbs across. Interesting, like a little different, right? Full breath there, exhale, side bend to your left. Okay, I always try to take it easy with these because I feel like I go way too far too fast. So keep the feet anchored, arm bones are back. Breathe up into the right side of the body. Chin is lifted off the chest. Full inhale, breath. Exhale, start to bend a little bit deeper. Just kind of taking an inventory right now. Like, how's the body feel? One more breath in, ribs and belly in. Reach over to the left side, exhale. Then inhale, come back to center. And exhale, release your hands. Bring them right through the heart center and fold. Okay, fold, fold, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step your right foot back to a lunge and let your right knee come down. Keep your right toes tucked under. You can stay here. Or you can bring your hands to your thigh and kind of just give yourself some space. Push the thigh away. Open up the side bodies. And then arms come right back up again. Okay, inhale here. Exhale, side bend to your left. Your left fingertips come down. They might hit the mat or a block. They might not. It doesn't matter. I don't want to see like this sort of thing, like just to get your hand down, right? It's more about the side stretch. Good. One more full breath. Inhale. Exhale. You got it. Inhale. Bring both hands up. Exhale. Hands to the floor. Lift your right knee. Inhale. Good. Exhale. Step back to plank. All right, stay for your full inhale breath here. Just kind of recalibrate and connect to your core. And then you're going to come all the way down to your belly as you exhale. Okay, so this is a little bit different. Untuck your toes. We're playing around with flexed and pointed feet today. So you untuck your toes. Your left toes stay down. Cobra, bend your right knee with the chest. Exhale down. Okay, slow other side. Right foot presses. Bend your left knee with the chest. Inhale. So see if you can keep pressing your right foot down. And then exhale down. Good. Inhale, plank pose. So from here, elbows in, curl the toes under, lift the thighs, press up to plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Yeah, if it's too early for that kind of stuff, you know, you can always push up to your knees, right? Breathe. In through the nose. Out through the nose. Let's go right leg high. Inhale. Open up the hip and bend the knee. Exhale. So now notice if you've like leaned all the way over square the right shoulder down. Keep the fingers spreading. You're going to take one more breath in here. And then right knee to left elbow as you exhale. You're going to take it across the body, all the way to the left elbow. Inhale, right leg straight and square. Exhale, right foot forward. And then just stay on your fingertips or hover. Inhale. Exhale, step your left foot forward. Forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up, touch the sky. And hands to heart center. Samasana to keep. Okay, second side. Inhale, arms up a little bit quicker this time. Interlace your fingers, release the index finger. Exhale, side bend to the left. Inhale, come back to center. Take the opposite grip. Exhale, side bend to the right. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, hands through the heart center, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step the left foot back. Left knee comes down and the left toes stay flexed. Inhale, your hands to your thigh. Push the thigh away and create some space. Good. Exhale, reach your arms up to the sky. One more breath there. Side bend to your right now. Okay, so again, your fingertips may or may not touch. May or may not. Ooh, getting that entire left side to open up. Full breath in. Stay. Exhale. Just stay. One more. And exhale. Come all the way up as you inhale. And then exhale, low lunge. Inhale to plank. Exhale, lower to the ground. Here's that funky cobra. Inhale, bend your right knee with the chest look up. Exhale, come down. Inhale, bend your left knee with the chest look up. Right toes push. Exhale, come down. Curl both toes under, lift the thighs, inhale to plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. All right, inhale, left leg high. Open up the hip and bend the knee. Again, square the left shoulder down. Enjoy just the sensation in the right leg, and the heel, and the calf. Just take a few breaths there. In through your nose. Exhale, find the alignment in your upper body. Upper arm bones are spiraling away from the middle so that you feel connected. Connected into your core. The arms are just extensions of the rib cage and the shoulder girdle. See if you can sense that. And then exhale, left knee to right elbow. Take a second pause there. Just give it a tap. And then inhale, left leg high. Exhale, step it forward. And you stay on the ball of your right foot or you hover for a breath. And then exhale, step the right foot into the left and fold all the way down. Let's go halfway lift as you inhale. And then bend your knees and hop your feet wider than the mat, just go wider. And then turn your heels in and toes out. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, malasana. Okay, if that's too narrow or too wide, just make that adjustment for yourself. Yep, and you can stay here or inhale, right arm reaches, twist to your left. Yep. There it is. Maybe a bind, if you're binding or choosing to bind, you can wrap your left arm behind your back and wrap your right arm in front of the right calf. If it doesn't work, don't worry about it. Yeah, just keep turning open. It's early. Hands back to heart center, inhale. Twist to your left, exhale. And sides are different too, right? Sometimes you twist to one side and work something's more available. Maybe a full bind. And another breath in. And then exhale, hands to heart center. You can stay here, take a breath. Okay, exhale, sit down. Without falling. So I'm going to turn so you can see what I'm going to do, but you're going to find like a Navasana variation. So my spine is still going to go like that, okay? But take your hands and wrap them under your calf muscles, and it takes a second just to get here. So in, which is funny because this is a yoga pose, okay, holding your legs like this, but if you've ever done Pilates before, it's a Pilates exercise called seal, where you wrap your arms under your shin bones and you hold your feet and you tap your feet like this. So I always see all these relationships between Pilates and yoga, and I'm like, oh, that's so cute. You really used some inspiration there, right? So you bring the thumb and the index finger together and you use the resistance right there between your forearms and your shins. And then you bring the heart forward again and you bring the big toes to touch. So it's just a very fun variation of both. And then it relaxes the hips a little bit too. And then release your hands and just bring your knees together, and there you are in both. And it might even feel kind of good to be here, right? Shoulders are down, heart is lifted. Take a breath in. And if you want, exhale half boat. And then inhale to boat. And exhale half boat. And inhale to boat. Like, not even a big deal, right? You just exhale and inhale. Finding that breath. Exhale. And inhale. Good. Just do two more. Exhale. And inhale. One more. Exhale. And inhale. Okay, just hold and smile. Yay. One more breath in. Maybe extend the legs. Oh, wow, look at y'all. And exhale. Cross your ankles. Good job. Step or float back. Vinyasa. So chaturanga, hit the deck. And then wait for it. Here it is. Inhale, little cobra with the right knee bends. Maybe. See if you can touch. Exhale down. And then again, left knee bends. Cross and lift. And then down. Curl the toes under, inhale, plank. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Good, take a deep breath in, and then a big exhale out your mouth. Just go, huh. Yeah, inhale, right leg high. And exhale, step forward. So pivot on your left foot, and let's go to warrior two. Okay. And then relax your shoulders. And maybe look back at your left hand and sort of move your left side body over a little bit. And then look back at over your right fingertips and bend your right knee half an inch deeper. Good. And a full breath there. And then you're going to make fists with your hands as you exhale. And then bend your left elbow, inhale, archer's pose. So the elbow bends in, the left shoulder blade slides across. And the right arm reaches up to the sky, almost like a reverse warrior, but different. Right knee is staying bent. That fist is going straight up to the sky. Just pretend like you've got your bow and arrow. One more breath in. Now just come back to warrior two and bring your hands to your heart center. Exhale. And then open up the arms. Inhale, like Tai Chi. Yeah. And then extended side angle. Exhale. Right hand down, left arm over. Now either forearm to thigh, or you could go fingertips to floor. Left arm can go sky high, or you can reach it over and start to kind of point your fingertips towards the lake. Yeah, so you're getting even longer and turning your heart to the sky. Go ahead and take another breath in. And then exhale, both hands to the floor. Low lunge, inhale, and you can either just step back to downward facing dog or vinyasa your way. So go ahead and take chaturanga, either dandasana, or you can just come down, inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. And then exhale, downward facing dog. You can take ashtanga namaskar from the knees, any variation that suits you. You can skip the whole thing, right? Inhale, left leg high.
Be in this moment. Exhale, left foot forward.
Okay, pivot on your right foot, inhale to warrior two.
Okay, so again, adjust whatever you need to adjust, shoulders are relaxed, and then pull back.
We tend to kind of lunge forward. So look back at your right hand and just give yourself a pull back just a little bit. And then bend your left knee a little more, and then look over your left fingertips. Good, one more breath in there, and then make fists with your hands on the exhale breath. Then inhale, archer's pose. That arm just bends in, and you hug the right shoulder blade in, and you should feel your right lat engage there. And the left fist to the sky. Breathe here. One more. Inhale. You're going to stay for that exhale. Then just come back to warrior two and just bring your hands to heart center. Inhale. And then open the arms. Exhale. Just like facing dog. Okay, so come down onto your knees and find child's pose. Watch your walk your arms forward and curl your toes under. So you're like extended child. And just pause for a beat. So we're gonna flow that sequence several times. I don't know, maybe two, maybe three times. The one pose that I skipped was a reverse warrior, so it'll be simple. You'll be able to follow. What I want to encourage you to do is just really connect to your breath. Okay, connect to the breath in every pose. So the breath is guiding you throughout the whole thing, and that's where the meditation is. That's where equanimity is. That's where the practice is. It's right in that breath. Okay, so even if you're opening up arms, unite the breath with the opening, right? It takes about two to three seconds to get the arms to open wide. And so that full breath takes the arms to open, right? One more breath in here. Stay for your exhale. Inhale, come back to hands and knees. And here we go. Exhale, downward facing dog. So like you're moving through water, right? Inhale, right leg high. Exhale, step your right foot forward. Pivot on your left foot. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, fists. Make your fists on the exhale. Inhale, archer's pose. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, open up the arms. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse warrior all the way up. Exhale, low lunge. Either step back to down dog or vinyasa, take it your way. Inhale, upward facing dog or cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg high. Just follow your breath up. Exhale, step your left foot forward. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, make your fist. Inhale, archer's pose. Exhale, hands to right center. Inhale, open up the arms. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, vinyasa. Take it your way. Move through your little lunge. Step back and lower. Inhale, cobra or up dog. It's so pretty. Exhale, downward facing dog. One more time through. Inhale, right leg high.
Exhale, step forward. It really feels like a renewal. Inhale, warrior two.
Exhale, make your fists. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, open the arms. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, vinyasa. Your way. Again, take it in. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, step it through. Inhale, warrior two. Follow your breath. Exhale, making your fists. Inhale, archer's pose. Exhale, hands back to heart center, back to intention. Good. Open it up. Inhale. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse warrior. And exhale, hands to the floor. Step back and lower. Inhale, upward facing dog or cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Let's pause in down dog. Lift both of your heels up high. Inhale. And then just swivel them to the left, okay? So you're pushing the floor away with both hands, standing on your feet, and actually letting your hips sort of sway to the left a little bit, and you're gonna feel even more stretching on the right side. And let your heels come down. Yes, let them come down. There it is. So you should feel something on the right side. Yeah. And then come all the way up on the balls of the feet. Inhale. And then swivel the heels to the right. Yes. And then again, move your butt back. And maybe let a little bit of the weight go to the right side so that your left side gets a little more sensation. Well done. Then lift both of the heels. Inhale. And then exhale, step or hop forward. Okay, halfway lift, inhale. Forward fold, let it go, exhale. Halfway lift again, bring your fingertips in front. Another full inhale there. Stay there, exhale. I'm gonna release the foot and reach up, inhale. And then exhale, left hand down, left foot down, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift again. Exhale, half moon on the right side. So stand on your left foot, turn to the right. And your fingertips of your left hand, tented, right, or maybe hovering. Maybe a little mudra there. Possibility to grab the top of the right foot. Again, squeezing the shoulder blades in towards each other. This is very similar to what we did on the ground. If you want to try it on the ground again, you can. One more breath. And then release, inhale, and then right hand down, exhale, inhale, look forward, exhale, step, right foot to the left, and hold. Good. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, step back to downward facing dog. All right, inhale, lift your heels, so we're going to kind of combine a bunch of stuff. Lift your heels and swivel them over to the left. Okay, so now you're standing on your left foot. In order to get to the next pose, you've got to stand on your left foot. And then from here, take your right leg up.
Oh.
What? Yeah. So now think Ardha Chandrasana, kind of downward facing dog, kind of side plank with the right leg lifted. And then, whoa, maybe you can lift your right arm up too.
Oh.
Oh, maybe you can. Did we get a lot of falling over?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, so it's like side plank with the right leg lifted but slightly kicked out. Okay, good. So bring your right hand down.
Bring your right foot down. Come back to balls of the feet. Come back to downward facing dog.
Swivel to the right. See if you can stand on your right foot and then lift your left leg up. Okay? And if you can try that. Yes! Good job. You guys are doing great. If not, you're just lifting your leg and that's okay.
Yeah, it's tricky, right?
Oh, it is. Another breath there. And then hand down,
foot down. But you know what, Julie? We're going to do that in a second anyway, so don't worry.
Come down onto your knees, child's pose.
Okay, so at this time, bring your arms back and roll out your wrists.
Roll out your wrists.
Okay.
All right, so we're going to do that again. Let's try again. The second time's a charm, right? So, now, or the third time. Maybe we'll do it three times. Okay, if none of that works for you, then you can go back to this one, gate pose, right? When we did this, and we pulled back and grabbed the top of the foot, this kind of sugar cane gate. You can also just do side plank, like this. Side plank works. Right, which is basically gate pose as well. It's the same thing, except the leg's not lifted. What else could you do? You could come on the floor and do any sort of back bend sequence that you want to do. Okay, let me show you how this is gonna look. You're gonna go back to downward facing dog. I'm gonna do it facing you so you can see. Lift your heels and swivel to one side. Lift one leg up, lift the arm up. Once you have that, see if you can reach back and grab the top of the foot. Open it. Whoop. See, I told you we're going to get back here. So, see if you can grab the top of the foot and hang out there, right? So it's a balance because I want to go backward, like, a lot. So I've got to kick. Whoo, kick, 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 kick. Well, then I'm going to release it, and I'm going to step behind, which is what you did.
Welcome.
And there's our welcome, right? And it's just being playful and kind of experimenting, right? And seeing what's possible, and if there's no, you're not, it's just yoga. Yeah, so just try it. If it doesn't work, try something else. Okay, here we go. All right, so find downward facing dog. All right, we'll start just with that little swivel to the left, and then you stand on the foot. So now you know I want you to stand on it. Then lift your right leg up. And then part of it's just balancing and lifting your right arm up, and you're just balancing there.
And then maybe the second part is you bend the knee. That's very tricky, just so you know. And catch the foot. Once you catch the foot,
Everyone can step that right foot behind. I'm pretty sure everyone can do that. And then stand into wild thing, and there it is. Full, full breath in. Squeezing the shoulder blades together, opening up the heart. And then exhale back to plank. Let's do something here. Inhale, exhale, chaturanga. Let's move to the deck. Come all the way down. Interlace your fingers behind you. Inhale, down, shavasana should just go good. Relax the neck, stretch the wrists a little bit. And then exhale, release, hands under the shoulders. Pass it up, downward facing dog. Swivel over to the right. And again, right hand presses, left leg lifts. And you can lift that arm up maybe. It's like a side plank, but more interesting. I think it's more interesting. Bend the back knee, I know. Part of the fun is just falling out. Like, get out, fall out. Fall out. And survive. Yeah, fall out and survive, right? And then step behind you in a full breath in. Ooh. Yeah, and then exhale. Holy moly, right? Come down onto your knees and another child's pose and just breath. Good job. And roll out your wrists maybe this time, just kind of around and around. Good. And then roll yourself up and just take your feet out. From underneath your hips, maybe scoop forward a little bit on your mat too. I skipped a little vinyasa there, which would have landed us up here. Let's go to boat again. So find your Navasana variation, whether it's here or maybe your feet are on the ground and you're lifting your chest up. Squeeze your knees together and then bring your hands to your heart center. Inhale, exhale, twist to your left. And then center, inhale, exhale to the right. Inhale, center, exhale, left, inhale, center, exhale, right, inhale, center, exhale, left, inhale, center, and again, exhale, if you're doing these, it's like no big deal, right? Left and center with your breath. Exhale and inhale, exhale and inhale, exhale, keep squeezing your knees together, exhale, twist, inhale, center. Exhale, twist. Who wants to go jump in the lake now? We're in the pool, right? Twist. And center, one more. Twist. And hold it here. Maybe you lift your arms or your legs and you just take another breath and maybe make some fists. Super powerful pose. One more breath there. Whoa, go fall down. Maybe, yeah, let's go half boat just because I did. And then come back up, boat pose. Good, one more breath. I know. Exhale. Take a few rounds of breath there. So, got a surprise lemonade in my favorite cup. Do love it if there's a surprise there. Somebody put lemonade in it. Full breath there. Stay for your exhale. And then turn, you might want to turn so that you're on the long of your mat, long side of your mat. And keep, but you don't have to. Keep your right knee bent in and extend your left leg out. And then you're going to open yourself like you're twisting open to the right so that it feels like that side bend again, almost like you're in alignment, right, with the right knee. Or you could even turn over your right knee and kind of say, I'm going to keep myself turned that way. And then your left hand comes on the floor. Right arm up and your right hand behind the head.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. So you don't want to do this.
Yeah.
Yeah. You go this way. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Got it, Andrea. Yeah.
It's like we've seen everyone turn different ways.
I know. Just think, yeah. And now start to lean over towards me, Michelle.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so the hand behind the head is so that you don't start to fold forward, right? You're pushing into the head, and that gives you that open sensation. Once you know where your body is, you don't have to have your hand there. You want more sensation, you can either bring your hand down or you can reach your arm over your ear like extended side angle. Yeah, if you are really flexible, there's maybe a chance, maybe Mandy will be able to do it, just reaching down to grab the foot, and then you continue to revolve open. This one's interesting and very, yeah.
Oh, it's good. Mostly like a party trick, right? Okay, and then here's the fun thing, right?
So we go back to wild thing a little bit here. You're gonna come all the way up and rotate to your right. Right hand comes down, and then up and around. And this is like gate slash wild thing if you're on your knee.
Oh.
Yeah. And it should feel pretty good. One more breath there. Exhale it out, and then come back down the way you came. Awesome, switch. Extend your right leg out and bend your left knee in. Okay, and then turn towards the bent left knee just so you know you're not gonna collapse inward. And then right hand comes to the inside of the right thigh, left arm up, and then left hand behind the head. And then you're just pressing into your hand, yeah, to keep you open. Flex your right foot up too. There it is. Yes, as best as you can. That's it, John. There you go. And then you're either just like hanging here and getting, whoa, even more, or you can start to reach the left arm over the ear, like extended side angle. It becomes almost like a variation of that. And there's just maybe a chance. I mean, it doesn't, sometimes it doesn't happen on the other side.
Right? Sometimes it does, I don't know. So you just go where you can go. It is. Another full breath there. All right. All the way up, and then you look towards the left again.
So you're turning towards the left and push your left hand into the floor. It's almost like you do a little circle and open it up, and it's like a version of wild thing and almost like a dancer. Yeah.
Good. Another breath there.
And then exhale. Release it. Well done. All right. Of your mat. Walk a little forward so you know your feet are going to be at the edge. Reach your arms out and just roll yourself down. So coming all the way on your back, let's go bridge or wheel. So walk your heels in a little closer to your glutes. Arms at your side. Press your hips up towards the sky. And you're just going to pause there. You might just stay there, or you can interlace your fingers underneath you. Right? And take a bound version of bridge. Breathe there. Inhale through your nose. And exhale. I'm just going to take another breath there. All right. And then release your hands. Inhale. And exhale. Just roll down. Go one vertebrae at a time. One vertebrae at a time. Good. Take an inhale breath. Palms facing up. Stay for the exhale. Exhale out your mouth. Go. Yeah. And then go up again. Press up again. So you're back in this bridge version, or flip your hands to come into wheel, right? If you know how to go into full wheel, you don't have wrist issues today, maybe you try a little version of wheel. My wrists are achy today, so I'm going to back out of that one. But anything that works for you, okay? Mm-hmm. Good. Breathe. You could always, if you want to go in a wheel, you can make fists too. Sometimes you just need to fist and power yourself up. One more breath. And then exhale.
exhale, take it down. Okay, keep your left knee bent. Bend your right knee in. So left foot stays on the floor, right knee bends in. And then reach up and grab the sole of your right foot. So it's half happy baby. Now, if your lower back is sensitive, just keep that left knee bent. If you want to, you can extend your left leg. And just experiment. Again, just be curious, like, with what feels better for you today. And you're just pulling that right knee down to the outside a little bit. That's it. And let your head come down. See if your head can rest. Good. And then hug that knee into your chest and twist. Go again across the left leg. So the left leg is straight. If you prefer a twist where your knees are both bent, you can do that as well. Gazing over your right shoulder, your fingertips. Come back to your breath.
It just feels really amazing out here.
One more breath in, a lot of gratitude. Exhale it out. And then slowly bring your knee back to your chest. And then extend your right leg out, or you can put your right foot down if you bend that knee. Then your left knee bends up and grab the sole of your left foot. Try to keep your head down. And your right leg's gonna extend out in front of you.
Good, breathe here.
Inhale through your nose and exhale. So good, you guys. One more breath here. Inhale.
Yeah, if you want to straighten that leg, you can a little bit. That's fine.
Okay, and then it bends and it goes across, so twist it out.
Twist. Left arm is extended. And you're using your right hand and you're just gently pressing it down.
And take another two or three breaths here. And then come back to center slowly. Hug both of your knees into your chest. Both of them into your chest. Give them a squeeze. Maybe rock from side to side a little bit. And then legs up the wall. Take your legs straight up towards the sky. And I like to take my hands and just sort of prop my legs a little bit so that I don't have to work so hard. If you want a different inversion, you can do headstand. You can do shoulder stand if you're going into shoulder stand. Press the core away, find your version of plow, and then take the legs up, right? If your neck is safe, then you can go here if you want. If you know that there's issues in the neck or you're just not into it, just take legs up the wall. So the goal is just an inversion. Go upside down. If you're on your cycle and neither of those work, you can go back into bridge, lifting your hips for one more hip opener, or you can do happy baby, grabbing your feet and just sitting here. Okay? All of that works. Yeah, all of that works. Good. Breathe. If you are in shoulder stand, your eyes are open. The back of your neck is not touching the mat. And you're balancing on the backs of your shoulders and your triceps. And you're pushing your toes up. Point your toes. And elongate your legs so that your energy is going up, up, up. So you shouldn't feel a lot of tension in your neck. And you're gazing directly between the big toes. You should have a little space there and you're pointing those toes. One more breath there. The legs will travel back, so they'll go way back again over your head if you're in shoulder stand. And then you'll bend the knees, easy does it. And then arms to your side to roll down. Meet everybody within legs up the wall.
And then give yourself one more hug, inhale.
And then extend your legs straight out in front of you for Shavasana, exhale. Now, if you're not ready for Shavasana, say your lower back is a little sensitive, sometimes mine gets sensitive after a shoulder stand, you can have your knees bent And maybe the knees just touching and the hands on the belly, if that works. Otherwise, legs completely extended, arms at your side, palms facing up. And once you're there, take a full breath in through your nose. And a big exhale out your mouth. Go, ha. And just let everything go. Relax your toes and the soles of your feet. Relax your heels and your arches. The tops of your feet, the skin, across your ankles. Your lower leg bones. And relax your knees. And relax your thighs and your thigh bones. And let your hips be so heavy. Just drop your legs, drop your hips. Let everything drop. Allow your belly to get soft. Let your heart be bright and open. Your shoulders and your elbows, your wrists, and your fingertips completely relaxed. And the palms of your hand open and bright. Let your whole body relax now. Let both of your legs relax. Let your pelvis relax and let both of your arms completely relax. Relax your throat and your jaw and allow the tongue to drop from the roof of the mouth. Relax the inside of your mouth, your cheeks and your cheekbones, your eyes, your eyebrows, the center of your forehead, and your hair. Let it all drop. And just breathe. And let yourself be completely held here in space. Let yourself be connected. You are completely taken care of right now. Completely loved. You have all that you need. And all is well. Start to bring yourself back slowly, maintaining this level of peace and serenity, moving the tips of your toes, and just turning the feet in and out, rotating the lower legs,
moving your fingertips and your wrists. Keep your eyes closed and bend your knees into your chest. And just keeping the eyes nice and closed, dropping from side to side, giving yourself a giant hug. Body's so happy. Roll to your side. Rest for a moment. And then slowly press yourself up. And with your eyes closed, just find a comfortable seat. And bring your hands at your heart center. Eyes are closed. We're so grateful for our bodies and our breath. Let's take this final moment just to revisit our intentions and ask that they are obvious to us throughout the remainder of our day, that all the benefits we experience through this practice are available, and that we stay this peaceful, this connected, and this alive for the rest of our day, maybe even into tomorrow if that works. Take a full breath in through your nose. Big exhale out your mouth, let it go. Bow your chin into your chest. And open up your eyes. Namaste. Well done.